Hello everyone. Today I'm using the slate tray mold from Mold and Shapes, and this pour is actually inspired by Sherry's imagination. So hello Sherry, in case you watch it. And it's the first time I'm trying to do her spider pour, spider web pour. So yeah, there you see me using my respirator and also my safety goggles, and yeah, soon I'll be starting. Yeah, it's the first time I'm trying this spider web pour for a video, so yeah, please bear with me. And I know she does awesome work, so yeah. Anyway, I used this time the resin, the B20 from DuPont, and as I said, the mold I'm using is the Slate's tray mold from Mold and Shapes. If you're interested in their molds, just have a look into my bio or into my description box, because you can get 5% discount on every purchase if you use the promo code PT5. This B20 resin is a low viscosity resin, and yeah, there you see me dividing a little bit. I was not sure how much to use, so it looks a little bit not coordinated. There I put 2 pumps of the Ivory pigment paste from Colorberry and 2 drops of the pigment paste in pink from Armor Art. There you see me dropping 4 drops of I think it's the navy blue or night blue from Armor Art. Forgive me, it's a dark blue. This is a pigment paste, a blue one from DuPont. And finally, I'm using the white pigment paste from DuPont. Yeah, I was doubting a little bit what to do. And then I just grabbed it. I was a little bit confused, so please apologize. Yeah, I'm mixing this up and I take a scoop, and I hope it was not too much, because yeah, it's quite a big pigment. And I also use the color shift from DuPont, and I hope to have a little bit of a sort of sparkle. It's the Cosmic Crush Colors Chip Pearl. I mixed my colors already because I did this offline. It doesn't make sense, you know, if you just see me stirring my cups. So I was just stirring all my pigments, cleaning my mold now. And I go around with some clear. And I found later, I think I poured a little bit too much clear. But like I said, it's the first time I'm doing this really in front of camera. There was a hair. And yeah, if you don't try anything, you never know. So this is now first this pigment powder, mica powder. It's a metallic color. And I'm going first with that one. And again, I think maybe I should have done this a little bit less. But it's all about testing. Yeah, you know, sometimes you're just excited and you just pour. And on top is now my pink, which is a little bit toned down. Actually, when you see the real color, it's not as pink as now on the video. And this blue, which has a little bit a touch of purple. And I think this was also too much. But, you know, as I said, I'm learning.
And now my white. This is our Brilli. While I'm taping, he wants out. So I need to have a look what he wants. Always the same when you have animals with the voiceover. Yeah, that you see me putting my clear into my mold, and unfortunately a little bit blue is now in the center. Yeah, sorry, I have to open the door. And I'm torching a little bit so the resin moves a bit and I pop some bubbles. And then I was doubting what to do, so I used white again. Then the dark blue again, bluish purple, the pink. Blue. It's a sort of, well, I cannot really say teal, but yeah, it's a nice color. Torching again, and you see like waves in the center. Oh, there's now the other one being back. So we have cats theater. Yeah, I put some more clear, some more white around it. And I really think I was not sure with the white. So, yeah, the noises you are hearing is our Brilli. He needs to say I'm here. Yeah, I bought these silicone pencils, and this is an idea from Casey LaPierre, because I saw her using them. And these are awesome. So I have different sizes of pencils. Do you say pencils? We say in German, Pinsel. And now I'm taking my center. And it's now I have to actually look. I have to go back to the kitchen. I'm not prepared. It's a 3D neon blue triangle 3D flakes. So I'm putting them into the center, not too much, because sometimes I have the problem that I sometimes put too much in there. So I try to really not do it this time, and I'm trying to get them also a little bit down. Yeah, catching some, and there are also some bubbles, and just pick this. It always looks like I'm with my nose in the resin, but guys, I'm not. So please bear with me. Yeah, I'm putting a little bit of the clear into the center so it's spreading a little bit. Sorting them a little bit. And at that stage I didn't know at all what to expect because of my blue in the center. Torching again. And seeing the torch now, I wanted to buy a new one and I forgot today. You know, tomorrow I attend a market here in Belgium, and the first time I'm trying to sell. So I don't know what to expect, and I'm also very nervous about this. Anyway, yeah, my torch is almost dying. Have it now for 1 year and it's full of resin, and well, it needed to happen. Yeah, I have some leftovers, but not too much, which is good. So, this is how it looked after 1 hour. And the colors really blended and dragged into the center. So, I was very satisfied when I saw this. But I already saw outside, it didn't went too much into the center. It was only the last layer. So, well, it's unmolding time. And I wonder what to expect. So putting everything aside, it's 12 hours later. Because this resin is curing faster. So I could already take it out of the mold. It's a tiny bit bendy, but not too much. And now I'm curious. And yeah, the white is a little bit too much, but I like the center. I'm really in love with the center. And even though there's so much white, it has a perfect 3D effect. So I hope you liked watching my video. And I hope to see you for the next time. I love and leave you and see you then. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.